Gaming company Nazara Technologies has made its first investment in a sector that's growing fairly rapidly in India. The Mumbai-based company has floated a 10 crore seed fund to back ventures in the gaming space. And joining us to discuss that, Nitish Mittersain, founder and CEO at Nazara.
Hi.
Nitish, thanks for being with us today. And before we, in fact, talk to you about these news developments, it's really interesting because you yourself, started out in this industry about a decade ago.
That's right.
And, you yourself at one point were looking for an investor. So, what are some of your own learnings and, from your experiences? It's a very niche market, niche space that we're talking about here. Right. How different is it today and the potential in it today to when you started out?
You see, when I started out in 2000, it was very early days. I mean, mobile gaming really didn't exist. Online gaming existed, but it was very small. Now the market is totally different. You've got in India, you've got about 200 million data users on mobile phones. You've got close to 100 million smartphones. So the market has totally changed now, and it's only still at the start. So you've got a market that's going from 100 million smartphones right now to maybe about 300, 400 million smartphones in the next 2-3 years. So it's a very exciting space to be in.
But, gaming industry on the whole, and this is Friday and I love talking about gaming, it's probably the best time, markets are closed now. But, on a more serious note, gaming has always been very limited to some of the more international brands. In India, has it really seen that much of traction? How do you foresee the interest? How do you see the demand? And, which are those trends that are now catching attention of investors when we talk about the India gaming industry?
See, the India gaming industry is very unique in the sense that unlike a lot of gaming industries in markets like China or Korea or Japan or even the Western markets like US, the mobile gaming industry has been kind of preceded with a lot of online MMO type of gaming. But India has missed all of that because of lack of PCs, lack of consoles, etc. It's only now that with mobile phones in everybody's pocket and with devices, Android devices becoming, very powerful at low cost, 3,000-4,000 rupees, people have a gaming device with them all the time in their pocket. And therefore, you are seeing this sudden explosion of consumption on gaming and the market open up actually.
So, in terms of the companies that you're looking to invest in, what are you looking out for? And give us a little bit more detail on the investment you've just announced yesterday as well.
So, our idea was, having been in the business for so many years, we obviously garnered a lot of, on-ground experience in that sense. And we see this as a very sunrise industry, the mobile gaming sector in India. We see over the next 2-3 years, it's becoming a sizable business. And there's a lot of now youngsters, leaving their jobs, wanting to do something interesting or innovative in this space. But financial investors don't yet understand the space very well to fund youngsters at a very early stage. So that's a gap we thought we could actually plug. We can also add a lot more value in terms of helping distribute these games, helping monetize these games. So besides the financial funding, we can bring a lot more value add to these entrepreneurs or startups.
So you've already invested in, I think, 2 or 3 companies.
This is the first investment.
But I think there are a couple more on the radar.
Yes.
So how are you planning to pace them out in terms of, are you looking at, a couple of big investments or, various smaller investments? And you're also looking to add more to the fund as well.
So we have in this particular company, Hashcube, which is a Bangalore-based company, we invested, towards the higher end of the spectrum that we are going to invest. Our fund is like 25 lakhs to 2 crores. So we're looking at investing at least, I would say, one company every quarter.
So, give us a sense also in terms of, the kind of exit time frame you're looking at, the kind of returns you're looking at from these investments.
See, our objective actually is not a financial return, particularly, because we're a strategic player. We're looking at building out the ecosystem and working with these companies, learning with them, vice versa. So we've not factored in, what will the financial gains be. But nevertheless, looking at the, size of the opportunity, I think the Indian gaming market in the next 3-4 years will be a 7-8,000 crore market from the 1,000 crores that it is today. And therefore, I'm sure the financial gains will also be there.
Okay. Just before we got started, you were saying that 100 crores is the kind of potential that you're seeing going ahead. Just take us through that as well.
Yeah, see, the game fund that we set up initially is a 10 crore corpus, which is completely Nazara's own money.
All right.
We intend to increase this to about 25 crores ourselves.
Okay. Okay.
As the market picks up over the next 1 year or so. But beyond that, we also have interest from a lot of early stage financial investors who also want to come in with us because we have the expertise in, you know, identifying these gaming companies. They don't. So I think adding them in the next year or so, this may be more about a 100 crore dedicated game fund, which I think will be a fantastic thing for gaming startups.
I have one question. One of the games that got me hooked on to some of these, you know, mobile devices came out a couple of years back now, probably was Angry Birds. You know, you had that little bit of the smartphone, the new smartphone, the touchscreen feel to it. How far are we from somewhat of a viral game like that to be launched from India?
I think we are very close to it. I think with a lot of, I would hope that that game comes out of our studio and our company. But if not, this is a lot of vibrant activity at the grassroots level. And before you know it, you will have it.